Yeah, now this is Black Light, resuming from the description of Master Farah Muhammad and his mission to raise up the black men. He came to Black Bottom, Detroit, Michigan, on the east side, independent. And at this particular time, the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad wasn't in the picture. So he wanted to educate or teach the black man of the knowledge of self, the knowledge of God, and the knowledge of his enemy, the devil. So if I'm going to walk in the footsteps of anyone, it would be Master Farah Muhammad. Now, he walked, he chose, and Elijah chose him, Elijah Muhammad, to do the job. And he passed on the mission to the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Now he would be the second one whose footsteps that I would walk into. Now, the last person's shoes I would try to fill or footsteps I would walk would be, it's between two people, and I'm gonna tell you why. It's between John Muhammad and Minister Farrakhan. The longevity of Minister Farrakhan is what I like about Mr. Farrakhan. What I like about Supreme Minister John Muhammad is he was there also when Master Farah was there teaching the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And he also has longevity, because he died, when he died he was in his 90s. So these four men is who I study. Lastly, Detroit, Michigan has a very significant role to play. And those 1967 uprising had a very key role to play. Coleman Young had a very key role to play. Berry Gordy, key role. Don Barton, very key role. R.J. Watkins, a very key role. And I'm gonna put it all together. So I want all of y'all to stay tuned and see how this comes together, because this is the thoughts of the elder on how we can master this. See, once you get knowledge of self, you can independently feed yourself. As others have done and are doing, you know, they doing their thing, you know, they call them splinter groups, but they are independently feeding themselves and their flock, or their the ones that are blessed. Because your flock, you know, it's not that you choose the flock. The flock chooses you. You know, your students choose you. Just like in college, you know, a college, it's the students' choice of what professor's class they want to enroll in or take, you know. And if they like your class, if your course or class suits them, they will choose you, you know. And then if they like the way you teach, you'll study up under them. If we like the way the professors teach, we'll study up under them. I'm not a teacher, although I can be. I consider myself a counselor. In other words, I give you an alternative viewpoint on how to deal systematically with this system. So, in school, you got a counselor, you have teachers, but you also have counselors, you know, to advise you what moves to make, you know, what teacher to study, what classes to take, what you need, what direction to go in. That's what the counselors do. But a universal or a council of the elders points the way 360 degrees, what you need to do. Remember this: survival is not a religion. Survival is a way of life. Once you master at a certain age, you're going to master surviving. If you live to be a certain age or longevity, you're going to be able to master surviving. And if you master surviving, you are able to master living life. It's a lot of study, a lot of observations, a lot of research, just like in school. So this system here is full of booby traps, full of trickery. And you can't neglect anything. To be continued. Black Light Out.